Steve Carell is a comedy icon at this point, but he's certainly missed out on some major roles over the years.
No, Kelly Clarkson!
Carell was performing at Chicago's Second City alongside Stephen Colbert when he auditioned for the British version of improv series Whose Line Is It Anyway in the early 90s, but failed to land the job. Lorne Michaels has said Carell was in the running for Saturday Night Live in 1995, the same year his wife, Nancy Carell, and future collaborators Will Ferrell and David Koechner were cast. However, Carell has disputed he actually auditioned.
As you can tell, someone didn't forget to take their stupid pills this morning.
Carell instead booked The Dana Carvey Show, and that shows the ambiguously gay duo animated videos with Colbert eventually migrated to SNL. He also landed a breakthrough role as a correspondent on The Daily Show in 1999. As director co-writer Adam McKay was casting Anchorman, The Legend of Ron Burgundy, James Spader was lobbying for the part of Brick Tamlin, but the director felt he was, quote, too good for the role, and instead cast Carell fresh off 2003's Bruce Almighty based on this audition.
I'm Brick Tamlin. People seem to like me because I am polite and I am rarely late.
Around the same time, NBC set out to remake the acclaimed British sitcom The Office, and Paul Giamatti, Hank Azaria, and Martin Short were among the names considered for the lead role of Michael Scott. After Jeremy Piven was offered the role and passed, Bob Odenkirk was cast. However, when Carell's sitcom Come to Papa was canceled after just 4 episodes, NBC brought him in to replace the eventual Saul Goodman. In the landmark comedy, Carell earned 6 consecutive Lead Actor Emmy nominations and gave meme makers a mountain of material.
I declare bankruptcy!
Anchorman star and co-writer Will Ferrell offered Carell an unspecified role in 2006's Talladega Nights, The Ballad of Ricky Bobby, but he had to pass over scheduling conflicts with the Oscar-nominated Little Miss Sunshine, a role he was offered after Bill Murray passed. Carell then signed on to play Harvey Milk in a biopic in development called The Mayor of Castro Street, but the project came to a halt when a similar movie, 2008's Milk, went into production first, earning Sean Penn an Oscar in the title role. Around that time, Carell was also rumored to be in consideration for the Joker in Christopher Nolan's The Dark Knight after he said publicly he was interested, but Nolan reportedly had Heath Ledger in mind all along.
All right, so listen, why don't you give me a call when you want to start taking things a little more seriously?
Carell was also at one point linked to cult favorite Party Down. The series was originally sold to HBO in 2003, with Paul Rudd in the lead role of Henry Pollard and Carell in discussions to play Ron Donald. When the show moved to Stars, however, Adam Scott took over for Rudd, and Ken Marino was cast as Ron. Carell was originally attached to 2010's Furry Vengeance, but departed after making another animal comedy, Evan Almighty. Jeremy Piven signed on for a time before the role went to Brendan Fraser.
I am successful, I am powerful, I am handsome, I am happy. Successful, powerful, handsome, happy.
Similarly, Carell was the first actor attached to 2011's The Beaver, but fell off and was replaced by Jim Carrey and then eventually Mel Gibson. And Carell and Dustin Hoffman were at one point set to star in the 2011 birdwatching comedy The Big Year, but were eventually replaced by Owen Wilson and Steve Martin after Carell had scheduling conflicts with Crazy Stupid Love.
You're late.
Yeah, sorry.
Carell was offered Dennis Dupree in 2012's Rock of Ages, but passed, as did Will Ferrell, and Alec Baldwin was eventually cast. Since then, Carell has kept his massive Despicable Me franchise going, as well as working his dramatic chops in Morning Show, The Big Short, Beautiful Boy, and Foxcatcher, which earned him an Oscar nomination.
I want, more than anything, to win a gold medal.
Carell now stars in Netflix's comedy Space Force, which he created with The Office helmer, Greg Daniels.
This is going to be a very good year. Very good.